guitar.
It's good. Good job there.
Thanks, man.
Nice. Good job.
I received a project this morning that I think Ramsey and Tanvir will be pretty happy about. Let's check it out.
Yeah, let's call it. We'll call it the new camouflage lawnmower. Yo, they won't even see it coming, man.
Hey, hey guys.
Hey, Billy.
Got a new job.
Really?
Yeah. We're in business.
Woo!
All right.
Let's
come on.
Go. Let's go. All right, so Billy came to us with this new job, and I was the skeptic at first because he's not the smartest one in the group. See, I'm the brains of the group. So hopefully it works out.
Alright boys, our customer was kind enough to donate 50 meters of chain link fence to us for completion of a fence in their very yard. And now we need to find the dimensions that will give us the maximum possible area of coverage in their yard. So...
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright.
Let's get a move on, boys.
Are we gonna be doing math?
Probably, Tanvir. Alright, so we got the 50 meters of chain link fence.
Yeah.
Down to measuring.
Alright, okay, yeah.
So one, two, three, four, seven. Oh, found a piece of grass. Billy, this is not right. We're not.
I think we need.
We need to go back to the drawing board.
Drawing board. Yes.
Okay. Oh, come on. Okay, so. Let's pretend that this face that Tamra drew is our fencing area, meaning that the lawn is around it. So draw some grass.
Oh, so there's like grass here.
Yeah.
Nice little blades of grass all around.
We have 50 meters of fence, right? Okay, I think it's enough grass there.
Yeah, okay.
And let's call this X up here.
Oh, and then this could be Y.
Yeah, perfect. Perimeter equals 2X plus 2Y. And the perimeter is 50 meters, because that's what she gave us, right? So we can rearrange this to y equals 25 minus x.
And you'll see why we are rearranging this after, because we're going to be using the area function to actually figure out what the maximum area could be.
Yeah, an area is length times width, right?
Yeah.
Length will be x in this situation, and it'll be times y. But y, we said, is 25 minus x.
So we're only going to be working with one variable.
Yeah, it's going to be easier.
So, are there interval?
The interval, yeah.
Yeah.
X. The smallest it could possibly be is zero, right?
We made y the largest value.
Yeah, so zero. And that would mean that the largest is 25.
Right.
Now,
because you can see right here, if we let y equal zero, because to make x the largest, y would have to be zero. So if you let y equals 0 there, it'd just be 2x equals 50, and then the max could be 25. Yeah.
Derivative next, right guys? X equals 25 over 2. Critical points.
A at 0.
A at 25.
Because that's what the minimum, we have to make sure that value for x will give us the maximum area. So we have to check our interval.
25 over 2. 156.25 meters squared. That's our maximum area.
X equals 25 over 2. And we can just plug that in.
For up here,
yeah.
Right? Y equals 25 over 2. So it's a square, guys.
Cut. Good day on the job.
Yep.
Hey, Billy, you want a drink?
I will have that water. Sure. Thank you. Hey, Ramsey. It's a nice cup you got there. I hear, you know, if it holds 50 centimeters cubed of water, then, you know, you ever wonder, like, the surface area of it? Like, how much plastic you need to...
Billy, can you... Billy, not right now.
Man, this is our job, Randy. This is our job.
You ruined it again, Billy!
Tanvir, you too. If you guys are both leaving, then you... Let me be the variable that you depend on.
Be the variable that they depend on.
Okay guys, we're back on the job. Let's get to it. All right, so we figured out the maximum area with 50 meters of chain link, so let's figure it out. Whoa, where's the chain link fence?
We're gonna have to drive.
We don't have a car.
No, drive. Look, I had a dream about this last night, all right?
Xavier, you know what to do. You know to derive. You must derive.
Do any of you have a piece of paper?
Yeah, I got one.
Come on, you understand this, right? Ramsey, do you get some of this at least?
Yeah, I think I can explain
it. Okay, explain it to Billy.
Okay, so the person we're trying to catch first went 2 kilometers down this dirt road, which is twice as slow, right?
Yeah, he runs twice as slow, okay, cool.
And then he went 4 kilometers down Lyman's Road,
okay,
which is on pavement, which is just constant speed.
Okay.
So, but we need to find the fastest way, and Tanvir figured out that if we take First Derivative Street, we have to do 2.3 kilometers on that, which is twice as long because it's dirt. And then we have
to run twice as slow on that because it's dirt, right? Yeah.
And sorry. And then it's 2.85 kilometers on Leibniz Avenue, which
is
already
paved, and it's a constant speed.
It's constant speed. But we'll get there before him if we go right now, guys. Let's go. Matt Davidson, and if your financial situation looks like this, it means it's slowing down. Pretty average day today. Yeah, a lot of work. Oh, okay. Just ignore me for the phone then. That's fine too.
Guys, I got some bad news.
Whatever.
We lost the fence job. Customer just got fed up. We were taking too long with our solution. And we failed the test. I mean, we failed to complete the job.
We don't need them.
But I mean...
Who did they give the job to?
The other guys.
Of course!
Oh my god, Well, I didn't learn anything.